And yesterday's COVID cases surged past 10,000. It's a worrying rise. So with COVID bubbling around our communities again, what's the impact been like on our kids? And as parents well know, when the kids get sick, childcare becomes an issue, not to mention the challenge for schools as they try to keep staff healthy and teaching. Perhaps it's no surprise Auckland's Carmel College has shifted back to online learning. Principal Chris Allen joins us now to explain how they're making it work in these final days of the school term. Morena, Chris.
Morena, Mackie.
God, 10,000 cases a day. It's just, it is a really stark reminder that COVID is very much still with us, right? And you must be feeling that yourself.
Well, very much so. We managed through the surge in March and were able to keep online learning, on-site learning the whole way through. And we've done it all year, but we've just come to the point with this latest surge, we've just run out of staff to be able to safely staff our school and keep kids on-site.
God, does it just feel like it's been the longest 2.5 years of your life, Chris?
Absolutely. And we've just had to be flexible and adaptable and adjust to anything that's really been thrown at us. And we've actually managed to do that quite well. And it hasn't really affected our academic outcomes for our students, but it has been a long struggle in terms of tiredness, exhaustion, and that's where we're at at this end of the term.
Yeah, so what are those case numbers? And I know schools aren't alone. So many industries, workplaces are feeling the pinch at the moment, but what has the impact been of this latest surge in cases on the school?
Well, we monitor sort of weekly, daily in sometimes to actually make sure that where we are in terms of can we stay on site. And we got to the last couple of weeks, we've been averaging about 20% of our students have been away. And we were touching on the sort of 15 to 20% over the last couple of weeks for the staff. And then this week, we've hit 25, 30%. And that's when we actually are running into trouble. And when we have run out of relievers and we have to get a reliever for a reliever for a reliever, then we know that we can't continue with what we're doing.
It's just not sustainable, is it?
Absolutely not sustainable.
So how quickly do you transition then?
We've got a really smooth, seamless transition that we do. So we've got an online timetable that we've used in the past. It's sort of been reviewed and refined over the last couple of years, and so we have it ready to go at any time. And we've just sort of told the students in the morning that, you know, tomorrow we're going to online learning. They all know what needs to be done, and we all just swap over to that the next day, and it's pretty seamless.
What kind of impact does that have, though? I wonder about what it does to the staff, to the students who finally felt like they were getting back to some sense of normality. We were back in the classrooms, back with friends, doing the things that we would normally be doing pre-pandemic days, and then all of a sudden we're launched right back into it again. What kind of an impact does that have?
Well, it's only for 4 days because that's still the end of the term.
Right.
So I think for the senior girls, it's been a real relief, really, because they've just been overwhelmed with their assessments that have had to be moved and changed because of the fact that students are in and out of the classroom. The relievers are taking the classes, so it's not their teacher that's actually taking them. So they have actually, a few of them have sort of said, thank you, we need this time just to take a little bit of a break, and it's only a very short period of time. I've had anecdotally from a couple of teachers that I've had the best attendance in my last couple of days online because the students are able to come online because they are at home or away. And one teacher said to me that she hasn't seen one student for 3 weeks, and there she was in her online classroom because she said, finally, I can attend and I can actually do the work. So that was, so for some of them, it's been a real bonus.
Are you concerned, though? I mean, you know, obviously it's only a few days until the school holidays, but if case numbers continue to go the way that they're going at the moment and we continue to have this surge and people are getting reinfected, then are you concerned that this could be a long-term thing where you're having to transition back into online learning?
We're hoping that this will be a bit of a circuit breaker for us and people will be re-energised and come back to the new term ready to go again. And again, we will continue to monitor and review and we will make the decisions as they come. We can't really predict what will happen in the future,
no,
as we know, through all of these last 2.5 years. So we just do the best we can with what we've got at the time.
I was wondering about longer term things. You know, obviously we're talking about a very short amount of time right now, but if I look back at the last few years, it's been a real struggle for a lot of people, and especially our kids, who have had to become really, really resilient in the face of some massive adversity. And I was looking at a study online that said the rates of mental illness among adolescents has risen by about 10% during the last couple of years. What do you do to support kids through that? How do you work through that?
So that has been an issue for us in terms of re-engaging the students into the classroom. I mean, we've had pretty good re-engagement, and our attendance has been fairly good all the way through because of our online timetable has set up to cope for the well-being, so it's got good breaks in it. They're not online all day for that time when they're actually online. So part of the way that we've been doing is we've reallocated some more pastoral care to it. Our deans are working particularly hard to keep them. We've hired some more counsellors to try and get these people back into a good mental space, and we seem to be getting on top of it slowly but surely. But I know that some of my colleagues are not in the same position, and it's much more widespread than just our school.
Yeah, that's tough, right?
It is tough.
And do you notice it on the ground in terms of students having more struggles, more issues that they're having to deal with than they would have previously?
I think there are a range of sort of ways that students show this, and I mean some girls have actually just bounced back and they're back in the classroom and they're fine, and then the few that we do have that are really struggling, of course we put those resources in to actually help them and make sure that they're engaged and they're learning, and we work with the families to make sure that they can actually support them in that way too.
What about their actual education as well? For some people, online learning, fine. You adapt really quickly and you make it work for you. But for other kids, it must be really tough, and they must miss that in-class learning environment. Are you concerned about the long-term effects of their actual education and learning?
Well, I mean, I was actually just thinking about it over the last few days. Our year 13s, this is the third year that they have had to try to do the NCA under very trying circumstances. Yeah. So for them, I think it is much more difficult because they haven't had a sort of a clear run at NCA. Fortuitously for us, our actual academic results haven't really shown that. So the girls are actually doing it. The teachers are putting in those extra hours, this extra time, and really putting in that extra effort to support them through that. But again, it is a bit of a grind to actually just keep doing it. So what would be really helpful is if NZQA could sort of come out with some sort of help and solution for us, or some sort of suggestion of how to ease that pressure earlier rather than later in the year, so the girls have some certainty about what's going to happen for them at the end of the year.
Mm. What's the next hurdle for you, Chris? Is there the next thing that you're thinking of that you're going to have to deal with?
Well, I think it's just the continual monitoring, keeping reviewing, again, seeing what happens in term three, see if the girls are actually sort of affected by this, and then again, continuing to support them, making sure that we've got a lot of pastoral care in there to check to see that they're actually getting the results and the credits that they need to go to the actual externals that they want to do, and making sure that their career paths are not affected by this. And so we're putting a huge amount of effort into our year 13s because they're the ones that don't have a chance to come back and make it up the following year. So that's the one, and I know with my colleagues, that's the year group that most people are concentrating on. The ones who are exiting at the end of this year need that extra support, and we've done that the last 2 years for the year 13 girls.
Well, fingers crossed this is just a blip and that we can get through the school holidays and get back to some sense of normality. Chris, thank you so much for joining us. It's Chris Allen from Carmel College. We really appreciate it.